scary to perform in this little pit of wires up here. If I'm electrocuted while doing this song, this might get a good one. So recently we were all thinking about South Africa after Mandela passed away, and I've been thinking about it still, and so this is a poem about that.
Chacholosa, hey uncle Zimtaba, simela sepume Zimbabwe, when uyabaleka, uyabaleka, kule Zimtaba, simela sepume Zimbabwe.
Nur Ibrahim had 50 homing pigeons. He lived in District 6 at the center of Cape Town. Nur Ibrahim lived in District 6 at the center of Cape Town, where there were 12 schools, and Holy Cross Church, and Aspling Street Mosque, and the Jews on Harrington Street, with the immigrants and the natives, the Indians and the Malayas, the blacks and the coloreds. Nur Ibrahim lived in District 6 at the center of Cape Town, where there was Bickenstock Bookstore and Parker's Corner Shop, where you could buy paraffin for the stove, fish oil, bull's eyes, and almond rock, where you could walk down to the public bath, pay a tiki, get a 15-minute shower, and find yourself in between the businessmen and the gangsters bathing side by side, right there at the corner of Clifton and Hanover Street. Nur Ibrahim lived in District 6 at the center of Cape Town with 50 pigeons and his family. Now, take a city, Cape Town, divided into 12 districts. One of them, District 6, at 70,000 people over time. Now divide that by the Group Areas Act of 1950, and you wind up with what? I'll give you a hint. It's the same as if you were to divide by race. So you're left with a remainder of one apartheid government and one declaration of 1966, which stated that from here on out, District 6 would be recognized as a whites-only territory. So, no more Hanover Street with the thick smell of curry from Doubt's Cafe. No more Janger's groceries or Wainick school uniforms or Maxim sweeteries and the sounds of children, laughter, buses, merchants, song. No. After all of that, you are left with only bulldozers, leveled buildings, raised land, broken glass and brick. Not even phantoms will haunt this ghost town, because even their floating figures are not white enough. Nur Ibrahim moved the 10 kilometers to Athlone. He packed up his pigeons in their cages and left District 6 at the center of Cape Town. He left Peninsula Maternity Ward, where dozens of colored babies are born every year, and a soda fountain where you could sit for hours and watch the women bring their laundry down to the public wash house three times a week. He left his house on Caledon Street. Nur Ibrahim left his home on Caledon Street in District 6 at the heart and soul of Cape Town and moved the 10 kilometers to Athlone. And he lived there for weeks, driving sometimes past the empty pit of land where District 6 no longer stood. And the winds blew hard, and they swept the dust and the dirt and the broken glass until every blade of grass bent beneath the weight of what was no longer there. After 3 months, the droppings at the bottom of the bird cages had become 3 layers thick. So Nur Ibrahim decided it was time to let the birds fly free. Fly free so they could learn to fly their way back. And he knew that not all of the pigeons would return that night. And he knew that the next morning, some of those cages might not be as full, but he also knew that sometimes gravity can become a little too comfortable. So that morning, he opened the doors on the cages, and the winds that swept through Cape Town swept through and lifted all 50 pigeons up into the air into a cloud of feathers, as if to say, it does not matter how long we have been kept in cages. It does not matter how strong your gravity is. We were always meant to fly. That night, Nur Ibrahim returned from work, turned off the car, went around to the back of the house and cried out in pain, because there in front of him were the empty pigeon cages, lined with droppings and feathers, but no pigeons. because not a single one of them had returned back to him. And the man who had watched them level his house to the ground without shedding a single tear suddenly felt his mind grow fuzzy and his ribcage felt as empty as the ones the birds had abandoned. So he got back into the car to take a drive and try to clear his mind. And as he drove down the long streets of Cape Town, the wheel moved beneath his hands and he found himself on the abandoned roads of District 6. And as he reached Caledon Street, he slowed to a stop. Because there, on the empty plot of land where his house once stood, were pigeons. All 50 of them, sitting amongst the dust and the dirt and the broken glass, looking up at him as if to say, where is our home? South Africa, we sing a song of strength. We go on like a rolling train forever. We never let gravity become too familiar because we were always meant to fly.
Chocholosa, hey and kule zintaba. Simela sekume Zimbabwe, when uyabaleka, uyabaleka, kule zintaba, simela sekume Zimbabwe.
Thank you.